I try every day to make sure I do some kind of good for someone. That's my object.
It was supposed to be about the life of Reverend William J. Lombardy, who was a chess grandmaster, and he was the coach of world chess champion Bobby Fischer.
I loved Bobby as my little brother, and I tried to help him, and that's the only reason I stayed.
An eviction notice was posted on Bill's door. That eviction notice led our documentary on Bill up to the Supreme Court. But the documentary shifted gears since the courts didn't honor the Constitution and Bill was quickly becoming homeless. Even so, Bill somehow managed to keep up with his many projects.
It dealt with the homelessness in New York City and the problems that both working homeless people and people that just wind up down on their luck face.
Yeah, I mean, I've noticed a lot of homeless people in the neighborhood, certainly. There's a shelter on my block, actually, a women's shelter.
We have an ongoing problem in what is affordable. If you ain't got the money for rent, it ain't affordable, period.
Way I know for 40 years, because I knew some people on the street, I used to chat a lot with homeless people and try to help them. Hey, 40 years on the street this guy was, he would never go in a home because he'd rather stay in a cardboard box because his life was in danger.
When I got back in the building around like 9 o'clock later on that the next day, a person approached me with a knife and tried to stab me to death.
I know that people who go into the shelters, they are supposed to find them supported housing.
See, me, I work for Resident Energy, the gas and electric company that supplies New York with the gas and electric to 9 million customers. I've been working construction jobs. I've been in the system 2 years. Which they have all these buildings that's going up for affordable housing, but they refuse to get us out of these buildings, to get us into the buildings that we need to be into to move on with our lives.
In the case of Bill, he was both paying his rent and working, so they just fabricated a case against him.
I'm here outside of New York City Housing Court, which ordered Reverend Lombardy to appear for a court conference. After 30 minutes of the conference, they ordered Reverend Lombardy to immediately go to a trial without a jury. Let's take a listen.
Why don't we just send the case out for a trial right now?
Well, I'd like a trial by jury.
Didn't file for a trial by jury. Did you file for a trial by jury? Did you pay the jury fee?
I'm not going to adjourn the case. I'm going to send you upstairs right now to room 1166 to do the trial.
We read here from Federalist Papers, written by Alexander Hamilton, James Madison, and John Jay, the founders of this country. The friends and adversaries of the plan of the convention, if they agree in nothing else, concur at least in the value they set upon the trial by jury. Or if there is any difference between them, it consists in this. The former regarded as a valuable safeguard to liberty, the latter represented as the very palladium of free government.
Because I am not capable with the rapid eviction, which Judge Maria Millen, ignorant of the law, but claiming she knew the law very well, instantly tosses me out on the street.